So once again, the Animal Reviews is back. This time to review a classic from the horror genre. This is the Critter Hand Puppet, bought by many of us horror fans from a Starlog Press magazine or a Fangoria magazine back in the early 1990s. This critter was made by Distortions, a mask-making company that was famous for making a number of early 90s, late 80s horror masks, such as the legendary Predator mask and Aliens, Aliens mask, the Stan Winston version. This critter was not cheap. At least to those of us who were kids back in the 80s and 90s, you can see by this advertisement that the original regular version went for $40 and the deluxe went for $90. I will be reviewing the deluxe version. I paid a bit more than $90 for it. I did not buy it originally back in the 90s. I would not have been able to afford it back then, but it is a great piece to have, as you can see by the video here. It's pretty lifelike. It is a puppet, and it is a bit spacious on the interior. If you look at the interior here, the shot, I added a bit of foam just to give, you know, some type of pressure against the back of your hand while you're operating him. This guy is, it's the type of thing that, you know, it can wear on your hand a bit, be physically tiring by operating him, considering how large he is on the interior. Modeled after the Krite from the very successful Critters movie series, the Critters movie hand puppet is a functional, camera-ready special FX prop. Exquisite sculpting breathes warmth and humor into the normally nasty Krite. Quality craft from the same materials Hollywood uses and fully licensed by New Line Cinema. The Critters hand puppet is a one-of-a-kind collectible. As you can see by this photo from Critters 2, the sculpt that Distortions utilized was pretty, I like to say, dead on to what the Krites looked like in the movie. I mean, obviously it's not 100%, but anyone who lived back in the 80s and 90s, for Christ's sakes, with toys, nothing was dead on. I mean, you took what you got, and this is a perfect example of something that was pretty film accurate for what was produced at the time. Of course, nothing to the RPF standards of 2015, but for 1992, I mean, this was pretty spot on. One thing to worry about in collecting this type of prop, as well as any mask, for any mask collectors out there, we all know that you got to be wary of the type of hair that is attached. This critter has it seems like a good amount of yak fur on the back and some typical mask fur that has been glued on top. The hair on his chest, or should I say chin, has been individually poked through, has been applied, which I know is much more laborious than just gluing it on. So you can tell a lot of details went into this. But the hair on the body, at least in this version, which is obviously, what, 20 odd years old now, it's a bit matted. Not horrible, but if you look on eBay, you'll notice some of them are pretty awful. Something to consider if you're contemplating buying these. The paint is not a bad job, in my opinion. I mean, the teeth leave a little to be desired, but not too bad. As you can see, the close-ups here kind of showcase what was available in terms of paint applications in 1992. And as the story goes, these molds from Distortions were sold to a company called Creation X, which made some good products, but I don't view the critter as one of them. I tell you, flipping through old Fangoria magazines, I was one of those collectors that I would love to look through. Oh, what could I buy? What could I have as a collectible from this horror film, or any horror film? That was, whether it was Freddy Gloves or Jason Masks or those old ads from Clay Guy. I don't know if any of you guys remember those. But the Critter Hand Puppet and all the stuff from Distortions was just fantastic. When I got this critter off of eBay, I tell you, it immediately made me revert back to being 12 years old. You see these critters, at least the Distortion critters, pop up on eBay every now and then, mainly around Halloween, but you see a lot of other critter props, whether they're you know, self-made. There's a guy out of Argentina that happens to do a number of them. Some of them fairly good-looking ones. And heck, even the ones that are fairly screen accurate. I mean, their height and everything else to what was out of the movie. You know what, though? Something about it just lacks that nostalgia. Maybe it's just the old fan in me of this Distortions model. So if you have the opportunity to grab one of these off of eBay, despite the price, I think I've seen these go for anywhere from $100 to $400, depending on the time that you buy it and the condition. If you have the opportunity, pick one up. I tell you, they're not going to be around forever. And if you know anything about latex, latex, if left out in the sun, can rot quite easily and can become brittle. So if you can come across one that's in good condition, it's worth the extra money you spend on it. So, hey, thanks for watching. Please subscribe. This is the Animal Reviews, and hope to see you guys again. Thanks.